heartbeat, increase in heartbeat. You hear the thunder of stampeding rhinos, elephants and Jackie tigers. This town ain't big enough for the both.
Right, it's Matt, welcome back to the shop. And today we've got another one of these questions. Someone said, FrameFlex, what are OEMs and race teams trying to accomplish with FrameFlex? Weirdly enough, this was quite a good question, because Isaac also asked this last weekend. You know, he said, watching MotoGP and stuff like that, he heard that they were mentioning FrameFlex. A good example of this is that in 20-something, 2012 or 2013, something like that, they actually made some frames that were carbon fibre. And as far as I understand it, the guys handed them back quickly and said, we don't want these are fucking horrible. Why would you want carbon fibre? Carbon fibre is obviously light, it is very strong under certain loads, and it is very stiff. Now here comes the problem. What was happening was, as far as I understand it, this is only what I remember from hearing, was that the frames, the carbon fibre frames, were too stiff. So what happens is that you get on a bike, so just say you get on the 2012 version of whatever, the Honda, Repsol Honda one, you ride around on it, and what you can feel is, you can feel feedback through the bike. Not just through the frame, but through the swing arm, through the forks, everything, shit like that. And when you lean over and stuff, and you're really, really pushing, you can feel the whole thing kind of, well, flex. It flexes as loads are applied to it, and then you can start to feel where it starts to snap back a bit. It depends what that feeling is, but you can feel the flex, and then it kind of hits a hard region where it stops flexing, and that can give you a good indication of you're about to fall off. You're going, you know, it's too hard, it's too much. That's the feeling of, oh, hang about. And that can give you a warning. So when you bend over like this, you go, right, I can feel the bear, and then I can start to feel that it's going to start to slip out or give or whatever. It depends what the situation is. And it's a hard thing to cover in a video about of all the touchy-feely, sensory whatevers. So what's happening is that the aluminium chassis and all the rest of it, they have a certain feel to them. When you jump on a carbon fibre bike, it is that stiff, you know, really, really stiff, that the way that carbon fibre yields is it doesn't really want to yield whatsoever. So it's kind of like it's giving, it's not really giving, and then it gives, or the feeling's just wrong, it's too stiff. That's the problem. So they lose their what they've built up over years, their sensory feedback of learning the bike and knowing how it feels. This is why they do testing, this is why they have to, you know, especially when someone moves, so someone moves from Yamaha to, say, Ducati, they give them a lot of time on that Ducati because the bike is totally different, it feels different, the geometry is different, so they give them time and a lot of testing to get used to that feel. And in a sense, you can see it with some riders, that's the problem with Rossi when he went from Yamaha to Ducati, was the fact that he just didn't sit comfortably with him, he just didn't like the bike. He trusted the Yamaha, he knew the feelings of the Yamaha, the bike was the way that he wanted it. You see, and in a sense, that's the whole point, is that they're given these carbon fibre frames, they were so different, that it's like, dickhead, if I had 3 years to get used to this frame, all good, but I don't. Give me back the old frame, give me back that aluminium frame. Now, I know there's talk about BMW making a mass production solution to making carbon fibre frames. Maybe it's that chop strand shit they're doing, where they basically just squash it in kind of like a die-cast moulding and then just basically inject and shoot and away you go. What they're going to be like in the future, like I say, you're not generally on the road, we are nowhere near pushing what them, well, generally because of tyre restrictions, but we are not pushing them bikes to exactly what they can do. So it's really a concern for the MotoGP guys, not so much us as road riders and all the rest of it. But yes, getting the flex right, getting the feel right, getting the bike to kind of tell you, that's good, that's good. You can kind of do it with screwdrivers, you know, when you're prying something, or when you're twisting an Allen key. Sometimes you twist it and you can feel it's the Allen key that's bending, but the feeling of the nuts rounding off, or the hex is rounding off, or that tip's going to break, that is something you need to learn. And if all of a sudden you get a carbon fibre shafted screwdriver, it's going to behave very, very, very differently, and you need to learn how that, you know, that changes. So getting the right flex and the right feedback and all the rest is very important, especially for these guys going fucking stupid miles an hour, stuff like that. Hope that makes sense. Like I said, there's probably a lot better ways to describe this. That's just my description of that. I'm not a fucking MotoGP racer, or I don't do the TT. So my take on this is so. Hope that makes sense, and I'll see you in a bit.